Hey beauty, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm diving into a side-by-side comparison of Bounce Curl's two latest brushes, the Volume Edge Lift Brush and the new Edge Lift Brush, but in pink. Both promise great results, but which one truly delivers? Let's find out. I started by prepping my hair with Bounce Curl's Moisture Balance Leave-In Conditioner and Clump and Define Cream. These products ensure my curls are hydrated and ready for styling. I always like to brush my hair when it's really, really moisturized to get the best results. This can look a little bit different for you. And here we go. We're going to part my hair in the mid partition, something what I haven't done in 16 years. So it's going to take me a while to do it. But if you're wondering what is that spot right smack in the middle of my forehead, that's just my gray spot. All my gray hair grows from there and it looks like a bald spot, but it's not. First up, the Volume Edge Lift Brush. Here's what not to do with the brush. This was the first time I was using it, so I took my hair just vertically and I did this. But if you notice, my hair does not look curly at all. So I decided to section it this way and use the brush by taking horizontal partitions. This brush has tiny bristles designed to give you more volume by dividing each curl clump into smaller clumps. I applied it to the left side of my hair. The idea here is that smaller clumps mean more defined and voluminous curls, like fuller curl. I like to brush and shake because even if some curl clumps are straying, they might come back when I shake them in their natural curl pattern. Now for the right side, I use the Edge Lift Brush in pink. It's a fan favorite, but does it hold up against the Volume Edge Lift Brush? Let's see how it performs on this side. I work through each section, brushing and clumping my curls. It's important to note that I never brush my hair with gel, just the moisturized curls. Brushing with gel can lead to unwanted frizz and disrupt the curl pattern for me. I like how this brush can be used for many things, especially if you're going to make sections. You can use the edge of the brush and make sections like this. If you've tried this brush or brush styling in general and you've been brushing in a different direction, try the horizontal way. After brushing it through, I can already see a little bit of difference between these two. Watch till the end so you can see the results. Now, after brushing with the cream, I scrunched in a dollop of the Bounce Curl Light Cream Gel on each side to lock in the moisture and also the texture. The gel helps to hold my curls. And here's the final look. Voluminous and fluffy on one side, sleek and defined on the other. Both brushes offer something unique. So it really comes down to your styling preference. And most importantly, your hair type. This is exactly why I threw in a poll on my Instagram stories and I got some interesting responses. I asked, what is your experience with brush styling technique in general? So here are just a few responses. My girlfriend Nimisha was the first one to respond that it did not work for me. And it's clear to see why, because she has fine, smooth, soft, shiny, wavy curls. So if you have hair like this, maybe brush styling is not for you. Danya responded and showed me her curls that were in the peak humidity. And for her, brush styling helps to maintain curls through the week. So she washes her hair, brush styles, and then she gets like 4-5 days of curls. Notice her curls are a little bit thicker. This is Varsha, and Varsha's hair is coarse, just like mine. And for her, brush styling gives her ringlets. And here's another beauty, Yvette. Look at her glorious long thick curls. They are so defined because of brush styling and it works every time for her. So if you're on the fence and not sure if brush styling is for you, I would say that if your hair is between medium texture to coarse texture, then you can get the most benefits of brush styling because it's literally finger coiling your hair for you. So what do you think? Which brush gave better results? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below and remember to like and subscribe for more curly hair insights and practical tips. Well then, why?